convince us more today. I pray that we are indeed conquerors. Thank you, Lord. We look unto you. We depend on you, God. Holy Spirit, would you come and just make us understand simply your word and the principles that you are making us a conqueror. Whatever trials, testings, tribulation, whatever it is that we are facing, we can conquer them in the name of Jesus. Amen. A conqueror is passionate for God. He understands the power of faith. A conqueror prioritizes the presence of God. A conqueror is a follower. And we looked at last Sunday, the pitfalls of a conqueror. Kung titulan siguro to kada point sa itong Sunday, the pitfalls of a conqueror. Una sa tanan, first point siguro ito magkaitang asa naman. Muna yung mga pamutana sa mga nag-cut-out pa lang na mahimong conqueror. Asa naman ang panalangin sa inyo? Asa naman ang mga saad sa inyo? So many people, they're saying statements like, asa naman. But the thing is, they lack devotion. Because ang Ginoo naara ko nun ay, ikaw ang angay kong tanong, asa naman ka? Right? And the second point would be, ngayon ang kadaghanan ng mga nagkaton pa lang na may mong conqueror. Ha? Ako? Gamitin ko sa Ginoo? How many have asked that question? Like Gideon, ha, Lord? Sure ka? Ako? Gamitin ko din mo? But you just lack dream. As we get close to God, we get a God-given dream and we believe that we are conquerors. And last point could probably say ang sa pitfall sa conqueror is yan ang mayroon talang sure, Lord, ay, hindi mo siya kumubanan? Sure ba? When we don't realize that God is on our side, when we don't realize that God is for us and He is not against us, hindi mo tapan, ang Diyos, nag-ubani mo. Tanunay. And this morning, I will share the final part of this series. As I always say, as disciples, it is in our DNA to conquer. Our job description is to conquer. Let me tell you something, winners are ex-losers who got mad. How many are ready to get mad? I'm just so tired of this. I'm gonna win. I'm so tired of losing. Winners are ex-losers who got mad. We're going to look at three examples of ordinary people who got tired of being afraid. Ikapwede sila may mong timid. They're tired of being sick. They're tired of losing. And simply, they are tired of being tired. And they're just sick of it. In other words, these people, they became conquerors. That's what I have been sharing since day one, that we are conquerors. The Holy Spirit wants us to believe, and the Holy Spirit will deposit in us faith that we can be conquerors. As I said, unless the pain of change is lesser than the pain of staying the same, no one will change. We must be sick and tired of being sick and tired. We must desire change in our lives, and in order for us to change, it's about time that we conquer. It's about time that we face our issues and grab it by its neck. And even siya, I am a conqueror. I'll win this trial. I'll win this battle. It's about time that we quit yapping. We quit, you know, complaining. We quit murmuring. And it's about time that we say, Lord, I'm gonna win because you are on my side. Lord, I'm gonna stop doubting. Lord, I'm gonna start devoting myself to you. Lord, I'm going to start drawing near to you because I know my conquest is dependent on my devotion to you. Lord, it's about time that I follow you wholeheartedly. Lord, it's about time that I devote myself to you. Okay, Lord, it's about time that I do not reject my calling. And Lord, it's about time that I get in touch with people who are conquering, just like myself, the rest. It's about time that we conquer. These people, these three people that I'm going to mention this morning, they became conquerors. Sila itong mga ordinary na nakadawat o extra ikan sa Ginoo. Sila itong mga nobodies who became somebody. So diya, maka-encounter sila sa Ginoo. These are people who were natural, but they got super. Because God is with them. Traits of a conqueror. Man. Every time the people of God are in trouble, He would always send someone to help them. How many of you were in a situation wherein ang hinahanglan kang tabang, yan ay itabangin mo? Anybody? Hinahanglan kang kwarta, yan, itabang sa inyo. You cried out for help, right? No? Hinahanglan ka o, hinahanglan ka bugas, niya, walang kimakaon, niya, kalit lang, hinahanglan mo o, whitey, kalit lang, hinahanglan mo o, kanang sudan. How many of you knows what I'm talking about? Huwag yun mo nang inahanglan sa God. Every time the people of God are in trouble, He would always send someone to help them. Now, if we are the ones being helped, we're not yet the conqueror. But when we become the people, the one who extends help, then that is a conqueror. God used conquerors in the Bible to help out the people of God. Most of the time, these conquerors, they're not really those special people. In fact, as to Caleb, as to Peter, and as to Gideon, they were ordinary people. Some are even timid, and one is a fisherman, and Caleb was an old man. They were not that special. But God used them. Amen. That's good news to all of us. God can use us. God can use you. He uses men and women who are willing for Him to use whatever gifting He has placed on them. Believe me, nakigasa. Naagay hiyas ang gihatag sa Ginoo. Believe me, you are a conqueror. I'm telling you, you are a conqueror. I'm telling you, you can win. Just get mad. Just get tired of losing. Just say, Lord, I'm going to win. Lord, I'm going to make a difference. My lifetime, it's about time to say, Lord, I'm tired of being ordinary. Come on. Show me some extra. It's about time that you say, Lord, I'm natural, but get super, Lord. Let's get supernatural together. See, God doesn't use supernatural because there's no one who is supernatural. We're all natural. Somebody said, Mel Tari said, if somebody tells you you're a great man of God, don't believe them. They're lying. There's no such person as a great man. There's only a man with a great God. And we are a man, a woman, with a great God. So we can be somebody, though we are nobodies, we can be somebody because God is with us. Amen. And so I'm telling you, you can win. You can win. Moses, Solomon, Paul, Joseph, they had such gifting to place on their lives. And they allowed God to use those giftings. They allowed God to use whatever they've got. Moses at one point, Lord, what shall I do? You know, what do you have? A stick. Use it. Divide the water. So He used it. Whatever we have, God will not use something that we don't have. God will always use somebody. And if you have a body, you can be used by God. How many here have a body? Or you're a ghost? Only ghosts ang hindi magamit sa Ginoo. God has given jurisdiction to mankind to affect change during sa kalimutan. And only men and women, only mankind is given that privilege. So the devil has to use somebody. Like God has to use somebody. So if you have a body, rejoice. You can be used by God. Even Peter, who was just an ordinary fisherman, he was used by God. Even Matthew, who was a sinner and a tax collector, he was used by God. Many people, they need God in their lives. They're crying out. They may not be the people of God. They may not yet be born again. Just like the Israelites, they called out to God. But there's so many people around us, they need God. They need God. They've been crying out, help. And God has given us a message of hope. Are we the ones that will only receive help? Or are we the ones who will extend help? Come on. You are a conqueror. But you are a conqueror. We're going to help them, right? Somehow these people, though needs to be conquered, they don't want to be conquered. They don't want somehow a spiritual kind of help because they have stereotyped our word again, our religion. And these people, the devil wants them to stay in their predicament. And sometimes na sila pride, sometimes na religious spirit, sometimes na fear. And the problem is they don't know what can save them. But you are a conqueror. Amen. You know what's wrong in their lives. You know you have been conquered. And God won sa imong kinabuhi. And as a result of that, God saved you. He used a conqueror in your life. Every one of us, nakadol sa Ginoo, because at one point or the other, somebody conquered us. Somebody shared the conquering message from the Lord Jesus Christ. And so we received it. So we become passionate about the message, you know. And so we preach it. And so we live it. And so we get the benefits of being born again. And so we get the joy, not just happiness. And so now, people around us, are in the same situation that we were in the past. They're now immorals. They are addicted. They have these things. They have lots of turmoils, disappointments, and pain, and rejection. They had this negativity operating in their lives. They had this doubt. And daghang kahit na silang kinabuhi. And you know the solution. You know that there's such a kind of life that we should be preaching out to them. Will you dare to be a conqueror? Because I want to share with you this morning that a conqueror is a soul winner. Come on. You are a soul winner. Let's declare, I am a conqueror. Right? So, number one, traits of a conqueror or a trait of a soul winner. As I've said, you know, just three people in the Bible that are ordinary. Okay? First one is, who knows Jael? Kailan mo Jael? Kailan mo na ako ka Jael? Judges? Okay? Let me just give you a context. Okay? Before that verse, we know that after Ehud's death, he's one of the judge. Igabisi is one conqueror. The book of Judges is filled with conquerors. The Israelites did evil in the Lord's sight, and so the Lord turned them over to King Jabin of Hazor, a Canaanite king. And yung commander, ang alam, si Sisera. Okay? Si Sisera had two kaming tao. He had 900 iron chariots. In other words, masya 900 katangki ni Gira. Okay? I don't know pila ka po katangki ni Gira sa Cebu. Pero kung sumunod ang 900 katangki, listen to Gira siya. And so, but the people of Israel cried out to the Lord for help. Again, they cried out to the Lord for help. Now, unlikely, doon na yung saka inganlan o Heber, the Kenite, a descendant of Moses' brother-in-law Hobab, had moved away from other members of his tribe. Kani siya, part sa Israel, katawahan sa Ginoo. But he pitched his tent by the oak of Zanem near Kadesh. Okay? So nahitabuhan ni, doon na naigira na naghitabo. No? Sa Judges 4, kita na to. When Sisera was told that Barak, son of Abinoam, had gone up to Mount Tabor, kasi Deborah, the judge of Israel, yun siya, ignan mo sa Ginoo, musong ka. Let's mount up 10,000 warriors. Musong ka. Pero nandun ka ni King, ni Barak, ni King Jabin, kanya yung si Sisera na hadungog sa iyang plano. So iyang lina, iyang 900 gayang chariots. So kumbati na. So the people of God versus the enemy. So there was that confrontation right there. Now imagine, now,